Hello and welcome back to my Launch Complex's stream RP1. So last time we smacked the moon in the face, highly successful, got a bunch of science, got 10 free applicants. Money. Which launch complex is this supposed to be? I guess LC-14. Okay. Now, horrifyingly, we can fit 185 people in this thing. That's very expensive. So I can do one more of these until we get our star streak. We need to wait at least another 60 days, if not more. Okay, so I think cool. The code I wrote for KSP Community Fixes worked. Always nice when that happens. I was annoyed by the thing where when you right-click this so you can purchase it, a bunch of part modules show up. Because I did a dumb when I originally wrote the feature for KSP. Although it's possible that I did it correctly and then it got changed over time, but probably I was just dumb and forgot to turn them off. I think under the assumption that people would make fresh icons rather than reuse existing parts. Probably why I didn't do that. Right. So this. Oh. Yeah, we don't get the Altair until 59. Got. Well, that's annoying. So yeah, we'll just start up right now on EDL. It'll take a while, but that's okay. And in particular, I want to. Yeah, so that's December 56, and this is August Late August 56. Yeah, there'll be time to build a rocket after that. Basically, what I want to do is get EDL so that I can re-enter the advanced bio sample from orbit before I do the crude Kármán line contract and not miss out on that money. Do another one of these. Now, what kind of Delta V budget do we have? Let's see, eccentricity calculator. If our perigee is 330, our apogee needs to be 610 and 610 and 880. What delta V spread is that? Let's see. That's 78 meters per second to 150. Okay, so that's fine. I think that's achievable even with the unreliable thing we have. That's a dispersion of about 75 meters per second, and I think we can manage that. And in point of fact, we could have managed it with Vanguard now that I think about it. Yeah, I should have just done it with Vanguard. Hey, Senshi. Morning to you. Yeah, I really should have launched this with Vanguard. Although I guess maybe I didn't have the Delta V to do it with Vanguard. Okay, so our requirements are low Earth orbit plus about 500 meters per second plus 80 meters per second for the kick. Seven. All right, so we need about 940 meters per second. So tired of doing this. Oh, given that I've already unlocked the baby sergeant, maybe I should just use the baby sergeant instead. So we want 1480 in this thing. So quite that much. Should be fine. No, we actually we want to be at the midpoint, now that I think about it. So 75 to 150. So yeah, 112 plus 1511. Close enough. intriguing. That's enough to do to. Okay, cool. We'll be even better than this. So the actual cost will be $51.5. Okay, so 168 meters per second is the actual cost. Okay. We'll do that. Oh, am I on the wrong LC? I'm probably on the wrong LC. Yes. Okay. So yes, let's do this. And let's sim it, for sake of argument. All right, so what's the actual orbit? Okay. Okay, not what the contract specifies. Essentially because I already had a tool, because I built a 20-inch probe for Vanguard because Vanguard launched a 20-inch probe or tried to. Freeze. Stop at state. Oh, wait, I goofed. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that this will not work. I can do that. Yeah, we'll do it that way. Probably should have launched south, actually. Oh, wait, I was sort of dumb. Let's see. I want to. Wee, look at that go. Yeah, I think the eccentricity is going to be wrong for that. Might need to go rather higher. Five 25 by 756. Yeah. All right, that's not good. So that is not the maneuver for us. Four 11 by 874. That is the maneuver for us. That is acceptable. Basically, we can burn not at apogee or perigee to deal with however much delta V we actually have in these things. Spin up. High spin rate as we can get. There we go. Amazingly enough, we actually have comms. Didn't expect that. Okay. Eccentricity is right on the money. Inclination is fine. All right. That's fine. We'll go ahead and use this. Okay, so I guess the order doesn't matter. We could go to the moon first. I'm kind of scared about increasing my staff. But I guess I might as well get some more researchers. Before we really start to ramp up our engineers, build the next generation of rockets, which we'll need for lunar orbit, I think, anyway. Like, maybe I could do lunar orbit off what I have. I know people have, but the precision is worrying. terms of dates. 1956 March. All right, April 8th. Sorry, at 2 p.m. UTC. Okay, and rather than messing with so much by normal, just wait until we're only a little over 3 days. That'll work. We'll still have to correct our velocity some, but we'll see what happens. Hours. Perfect. Here we go. Oh, crap. Why are we not throttling up? Oh, it's unreachable. That's why. Alex. Here we go. Coming up on insertion. Oops. Okay, somehow I'm managing to screw this up again. Okay, the moon is reaching its AN phase. Which means that we want to do stuff at the DN, which is in 27 minutes. Okay. So we're performing the maneuver at the right time now. I did launch to the moon's land. I thought. I told it to launch to 257. And it launched me to 349, so apparently that is the problem. Thank you for suggesting I check that again, because that 100% is the problem. Not really sure why. I think maybe because I had a bad inclination put in originally, so it offset my. And I don't know. Try this again. That makes way more sense, though. Seven. Yeah, that's what happened. Because the inclination was retrograde, it launched me to the opposite land. That's clearly what happened. 22 hours, that's not great, given that it is already almost April. Okay, well, we'll see how this works. Might have to load my temp save. Or the other thing that I maybe should have done was launched 180 degrees off. Which would have had me come in at high inclination with respect to the moon, but I don't care, I just need to hit it. Okay, coming up on staging. And here we come. Okay. Skin. And long until our DN. Minutes. Now let's look in MEO, and that's much better. Yes, that's what the problem was. Okay. We have an impact. I'm going to guess that we'll burn more than. All right. Let's align and burn. Spin up. Now, let me use, I'm not sure I understand what you're suggesting. You're suggesting that I want launch such that my ascending or descending node is 60 degrees ahead of the moon itself. My understanding of the orbital mechanics involved is that you want to launch such that the longitude with respect to fixed stars where you cross the Earth's equator is the same at the latitude where the moon will cross the Earth's equator. At the time that both those occur. Be clear. Given that the moon's orbit is varying slightly. There has to be some prediction involved there, probably. But I certainly don't want to be 60 degrees ahead of the moon because As you can see from the delta V that I'm calculating, it is not going to take me 5 days to get to the moon. It's going to take me much less time. 60 degrees, I think, is implying a transit time of 5 days, but maybe I'm again misunderstanding exactly what you're suggesting. Alex Hudson, yeah, it's without by normal because I waited long enough to launch that my trend, given the delta V involved, my transit is fast enough. Sorry, the time it will take the moon to get to its node is short enough now that I don't need to artificially slow down my transfer, which is what adding by normal would. Oops. Okay, I believe we've established that we want to fire at 17 seconds, assuming the suspended delta V will be equivalent in this case. We'll see. So close, and yet not quite. Yeah, I'm not sufficiently familiar with Principia to get away with dead reckoning. Like, I'm gradually learning some of the instinctual feeling for what to do to make things work, but it's still in the getting there phase. That's intriguing. I see what's wrong. All right, I guess we do need some. Oh, thank you. Yes, that's interesting. I did not expect it to not remember that default. That's not great. Yeah, that caused a bunch of trouble yesterday. I mean, not a ton because the effects of burn time are not super strong based on how high my thrust to weight ratio is, but they're strong enough that it's not great. Okay, let's spin up. Really need some velocity trim solids. Okay. Yeah, I will try with inertially fixed next time. I mean, it doesn't matter that much because, oh, no, I guess it does matter because that the prediction assumes you track the burn. Okay. That worked. Bye-bye flight plan, bye-bye plotting. Off we go towards the moon. Yeah, with only 300, a tiny portion of that burn actually being binormal, I would not presume inertially fixed to matter. I mean, I guess inertially fixed will also matter just because the curvature of the orbit will be changing, pumping that much delta V into it. So where prograde will be very. Even if the. Inclination side won't matter. I assume that we don't actually have any transmitting. Wait till we get to space low. Here we come. Again, we're hitting a new moon, which is not optimal. And there's an earth-shattering kaboom. Or moon-shattering kaboom. Contract complete. Okay, there's a big delta. Hiring a few more engineers. Getting there. So, all right, let's do our sun synchronous thing. Although I guess it's time to test. Okay, and then we get relightable upper stages. Deprecated. Why the heck is it still showing in the tree? Eventually we will. Get ourselves. Beta human spaceflight. Got a bit of space low from. Okay. Well, let's do some sync. How are we doing? Still wait a little. All right, it's done. Here we go. Inclination 7. Okay, we'll do that. And here we go. bunch of reserve repellent. Okay, so we want a perigee of anywhere between 295 kilometers and 560 kilometers. Minutes. Okay. That'll work. I will do that though, just to be sure. Go. Now we gotta spin up because there's no guarantee that we'll have signal when I perform the kick. Here we go. Okay. We are good. Contract complete. All right, on that happy note, I will wish you all good night. Thanks for watching. Later.